Hello everyone, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to discuss a tutorial on negative shareholders equity. We are going to discuss some of the examples, although on the same, the buyback and some of the losses related to the cases that we are going to pitch over here. The first and the foremost thing, you know, I'll show you an extract of the liability side of balance sheet. Now, have a look at this. Have a look at the Colgate's shareholders equity. I mean, its shareholders equity is negative, that is 243. And over here, it is negative 299. So, is negative shareholders a danger sign implying investors to stay away from the stock? Or negative shareholders equity is in most cases due to the loss accumulated over the years by the company? So, in this particular tutorial, we are going to look at so many other details regarding the shareholders' equity, so negative shareholders' equity. So, let's get into the nitty-gritty of the same. What is exactly negative shareholders' equity? First, let's learn that. At the very first and the foremost thing, what is negative shareholders' equity? So, let's understand, let's at the very first go to the basic accounting equation. Shareholders' equity is simply the difference between the assets. We'll just write assets over here and we'll write liabilities over here. So it's the difference between the two. So if you have 1000 over here, you have 500 over here. So the difference is the negative shareholders' equity. Now, in other words, it is amount of the capital that the proprietor brings in when the business is started. In the case of the company, it is the amount of the capital the shareholders subscribe to. Let me show you a fast track movers and packers balance sheet, and you will get some idea regarding the same. Now you can see over here, there's a fast track movers and packers balance sheet that is on December 31st, 2007. This is how the balance sheet has been formed. Here is the total assets. Here is the total liability and stockholders equity. So assets is equal to your liability plus your stockholders equity. So this is how the formula has been done. So as shown over here, the equity is the portion of the difference between the assets and the liability. So it also includes reserves that are accumulated over a period of time through profits. So if you are new to accounting, you may really go through the finance or for non-finance training. See, on the other hand, negative equity refers to, you know, the negative balance of the equity share capital in the balance sheet. So this situation usually happens when the company has incurred significant losses over a continuous period of time, such that, you know, they offset the reserves and equity capital appearing on the balance sheet. So it can happen because of the number of the other reasons too. Like I'll tell you some of the major reasons for the negative equity. The first and the foremost is when the company is over leveraged in that particular scenario, which means that there is a huge amount of debt. When the company incurs losses, this results in cash outflow. So the company generally borrows to stay and operate. This circle goes on, which generally results in huge pileup of debt. And company is incurring losses. Additionally, once a company enters into the phase of negative equity, it results in the downgrade of the credit rating, which further results in higher interest rate. Second, treasury stock repurchase. Now, see, as for the company's stock repurchase plan, the company may buy their common stocks. They results in the reduction of the equity. So if large amount of the common stock are repurchased, then it can lead to negative shareholders equity. The third thing is dividend payments. See, if the company has paid more amount of the cash dividend than the profit it earned, it can results in negative shareholders equity. Fourth is creation of provision. Now, negative shareholders' equity can also happen when the company has incurred or has created large provisions for the future expected financial liability. So, we have noted this, that, you know, the negative earnings do not necessarily mean that the shareholders have to give money to the company. Under the company laws, the shareholders are liable only to the extent that the money they invest in the business. So, in the case of a negative equity company, if they liquidate or dissolve, probably the shareholders are receiving nothing in exchange for the investment they made initially. However, if the company realized more amount by selling of their assets, it may pay shareholder even though there is a negative equity. So now my next thing is that how does the negative shareholder's equity occurs? See, let me explain this concept to you with the help of an example. I'll take you through the whole thing. First and the foremost thing, there's this guy called Mr. X. Okay, he starts a business of steel coins and he thinks that he has bought close enough to 1 lakh from the bank as loan. This is the amount of the loan that he has bought from the bank as a loan, and 50,000, you know, let me just write 50,000 as his own contribution, which is known as equity, right? That is known as equity because that's your own contribution. So now he has purchased the assets for establishing the business close enough to, let's say, 25,000 for buying a building and go down. So I'll just write building and go down over here as B and G. Okay. And 5,000 for, let's say, furniture. So all the amounts are in dollar right now over here. So furniture is 5,000 and 60,000 for purchasing steel stock as inventory. So I'll just write over here steel stock. So rest US dollars, that will be in cash. So the balance will be in cash. Now what happens? All set. So he went to start the business. So his opening balance sheet will appear something like this. Let me show you. This is going to be the opening balance sheet. So in the above case, the assets minus the liabilities, that is over here, you can say 1,65,000 less 1 lakh close enough to 40,000. So now this is the way the balance sheet will appear of Mr. X after inputting all the details, the balance of cash, inventory, building, furniture, which we just noted down, and the total of assets and liability will be there. So now, so he eventually started the business, you know, started selling steel. So due to this difficult business environment, the steel prices started to fall and he could sell the inventory of 60,000 at just, let's say, 35,000. He could sell at only 35,000 per dollar, incurring a loss of how much? 60 minus 35, that gives us $25,000. Additionally, he took a loan of 40,000. That was the additional loan of 40,000, and he bought a stock at $80,000. So the cash balance will be what? The cash balance will be which was 60,000, that was the original from our balance sheet, plus the 35,000 of the sale of the inventory, less the amount of the new stock that is, which gives us 15,000 is the new balance of the stock, which is first is 60,000 plus 35,000 as the sale, less the 80,000. So 60 plus 35 less 80. Now the closing balance sheet will be something as follow. Let me show you. This is going to be your closing balance sheet. Your cash 55, inventory is 80, building and go down 25, furniture 5, long-term borrowing 1,40,000, and your shareholders' equity, shareholders' capital at 50, and reserve surplus 25,000. So in the above case, the assets minus liability is 1,65,000. That is your assets less your liabilities. Okay, sorry, your 1,65,000 as your total assets less your liabilities, which gives us 25,000 as your shareholders' equity in negative. So let's move on. In the next year, let's say in 2017, the price fell further and the stock of 60,000 is sold for only, let's say, for 25,000. Over here, the stock over here is now of only 25,000 and at a loss of 35,000. That is 60,000 less 25,000, which gives us 35,000 as the loss. This will give us loss of total 35,000. So the reserves and surplus balance is, it was already in negative that we saw, 25,000 was negative, less the 35,000 amount. So that will give us 60,000 as reserves and surplus as negative. So the total assets in this case will be, 1,30,000, where the liabilities will be 1,40,000, making the shareholders equity negative. Let me show you that. So cash and cash balance 80, inventory 20 now, this remaining the same, long-term borrowing 1,40,000, and see over here 60,000, what we calculate for reserves and surplus. And this will go negative. Over here, there's a negative shareholder's equity, right? 50 and over 60, which is a negative. So I'll give you an example of negative shareholders' equity of Revlon. Let me just show you. If you come down and see over here, see the detail over here in yellow, as you see in the above snapshot, there's a huge amount of negative retained earnings, accumulated deficit in the Revlon's balance sheet, which is leading to negative total equity, right, as you can see. And the negative retained earnings are mainly because of the consistent losses from the operation, especially due to the slowdown in the Chinese market. So Revlon's total assets was 3023.5 million, where its liabilities was just 3638, that is the total liabilities, resulting in the shareholders' equity as negative 614.8. So I'll show you the negative shareholders' equity of Colgate. If we look at the shareholders' equity of Colgate, you will note that the Colgate is profitable company with a retained earning worth close enough to 19.9 billion in 2016. And its shareholders' equity is negative due to some of the reasons, which are as follow. The first reason was the treasury stock. Okay, treasury stock was the first reason. See, as per its share repurchase plan, Colgate buybacks its share each year. And we note that the Colgate has bought 19.313 billion of the common stock until 2016. The second reason is that they accumulated over other comprehensive income. I'll just transfer over here, control X, control V. So this is the second reason. See, this is the another reason why Colgate shareholders equity is negative. Each year there are other comprehensive losses that they are making, and that increases the losses even further. Let me show you that. Can you see over here the consolidated statement of changes in the shareholders equity provided us with the comprehensive detail of the shareholders equity section? If you see below the Colgate's consolidated changes in equity, we note that in 2016, the Colgate repurchased close enough to 1.55 billion worth of common stock also, and other comprehensive losses, net taxes, to close enough to 230 in negative in 2016. Let me show you that. If you see over here, the details are right in front of you, whatever we discussed. So in this fashion, we can take n number of examples to conclude. But there is one thing that we can discuss, is that the first thing, there's this thing called, does negative shareholders equity imply zero market value? This is the very important thing, because just because the equity of the company books it negative, okay, that doesn't mean that the company's share price in the market is zero, very important, or available for free. See, market price is always positive. They may be well operated in terms of shares price, and the shareholders may be very well be purchasing them. So this is because that the market price of the equity is not solely dependent on the book value of the company. It depends on the number of factors like company's outlook, operating cash flow of the company, the realizable value of the assets, and the company's past records. So I'll show you some example on HP. HP's data on how things have worked out and what exactly goes on with negative shareholders of equity of HP. That is HP company, you use the laptop. Now, over here, you will look at the shareholders equity section of HP. And we know that, in 2015, the HP shareholders equity was 27.278, okay, or 76 billion, whereas in 2016 it turned out negative to -3.88 billion. Why? See, the primary reason for HP shareholders equity going negative was the changes in the retained earning. If you note that, the changes in retained earning in HP was not because of the losses in HP. In fact, HP is profitable and reported their net earning close enough to 2.49 billion in 2016. See, HP shareholders equity turned negative due to its separation of the HP enterprise that led to the reduction of the shareholders' equity to in negative 37.2 billion. Additionally, the negative shareholders' equity was further compounded by the cash dividend of 858 million. Let me show you that in terms of the extract. This is the extract of the separation of the Hewlett-Packard's employees' data. Now, what are the implications of the negative shareholders' equity? The first is, there's an increase in the interest rate by the bank. difficulty in getting further funds, either through loans or equity, reduction in the credit period offered by the creditors, or they may deny credit sales. So there's decrease in corporate valuations in credit rating, and so on and so forth. So after discussing all of this, we can finally make a conclusion that since the net worth of the company represents its financial health, it may be a warning signal for the investors to exit the investment in case of the negative net worth. However, there is not only the factors that should be considered while evaluating the buy and sell decision.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.